I wanted to understand what it means to collaborate creatively with microorganisms, exploring new materials with them for jewelry making.
Scientists come to us usually with a need, and our role is to find a technological solution, making an experiment happen. The students coming from art school, they come with a very different mindset.
My project is called Al-Waqiya, which means the protectors in Arabic. And it was born from the moment where we saw students around the world being suppressed by the system just for standing for what is right. Through biofabrication, Al-Waqiya grows its own armor.
They take on innovation that we do here at the Crick, but they use it completely different.
We got it.
They shift completely the way we imagine how we apply in medical science.
These are oil paintings of micro CT X-ray images of lead contaminated lavender.
They actually use science and research as a media. Like a painter would use oil, they use microfluidic technology, they use imaging as a media in their research, and they get inspiration from it.
Biomineralization is a process where microorganisms are behind the process of precipitating minerals.
We start by bioprinting the scaffold here at the Francis Crick Institute. After that, we inoculated with asbesturi. Then we added to the custom-made bioreactor. The bacteria effectively deposit layers of mineral, the same mineral that makes up shells and corals.
I was able to make this scaffold with microchannels so they could travel through the ring, so they could biomineralize from the inside to the outside.
Each piece is hand-stitched, a gesture of care that bridges the microscopic world of bacteria with the human act of making.
One thing that's quite complicated about oil painting is that the materials you have to use are incredibly poisonous to humans. I was researching old Renaissance painting recipes, and I found that they would use lavender essential oil as the solvent for the oil paint. I was really excited to find out lavender loves lead, and lavender can pull up and bioaccumulate lead, and then when you distill the essential oil through, the lead actually doesn't carry. And I realized I could have this really nice system where I could heal soil, but then I could also heal painters in the studio. What I was mostly working on in the Crick was to see if we could visualize the lead inside the contaminated samples we had. I wanted to make images for my paintings from these microscopy images.
To me, it's really using science, innovation, and technology with a deeper social impact rather than a deeper medical human health impact. I believe that there is loads of space to use what we do on a daily basis for other purposes. And the students are here for that specifically. So they take whatever they learn here and they bring it elsewhere. So I see it as giving different playground to biomedical research.
The collaboration between the Francis Crick Institute and MA Biodesign at Centre St. Martin's actually opens the doors for artists to be able to express themselves in a scientific world. It empowers them to create.
Scientists and scientific imagery is as creating and beautiful as a lot of fine art and visual art. I'd like to see those worlds mix up a lot more because they're both so rich and I think they enhance each other.
Under the microscope they had beautiful mineral sculptures that I never imagined that I could have seen before.